If there's something on your mind and it's weighing you down, wondering about mental health, that's Patricia.
Hey, Patricia. How do you find time to take care of yourself?
Thanks for asking, Jon Jon, and hi, Paula and little guy. So what have you already tried?
Three things. One, going to sleep a little earlier. Mm-hmm. Number two, waking up a little earlier. And number three, making sure I work out first thing in the morning. That's really helped me.
Great. So a little bit earlier in the morning, a little bit earlier in the evening, and exercise first thing in the morning. Here's a different perspective you might want to consider, and that is sprinkling self-care through the day. So first thing when you get up in the morning, just ask yourself, do I want to have a little stretch? Do I want to have a big yawn? While I'm eating breakfast, savor it. Take an extra minute to slow down. And perhaps in the morning and in the afternoon, take 2 minutes to close your eyes and just be and meditate. And somewhere in the day, take 10 minutes and vigorously exercise. And I know a little extra suggestion we have from you, Jon Jon. You and Paula have something to offer families. Let's hear about it.
Paula and I have a great resource called My Name is Trauma. And this is a children's illustrated book that helps children and their caregivers and adults learn how to use play to heal from trauma and understand the effects of trauma on the body.
Wow. Well, thank you, Jon Jon and Paula and new little guy for joining me. So in the end, there's many ways to demonstrate self-care, all the way from getting up a little earlier in the morning and going to bed a little bit earlier in the evening to reading a book to our children, such as Paula and Jon Jon's My Name is Trauma.
Ask Patricia.